Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. For those of you who are using Photoshop version CC and later, I'm going to show you how to create this great jigsaw puzzle effect using a free plugin from Adobe, as well as how to create this retro Formica pattern background. Please note that this particular plugin will not work on versions earlier than CC. If your version is earlier than CC and are thinking of upgrading, click the link in my video's description for a 20% discount. Open an image you'd like to make into a puzzle. I downloaded this image from Shutterstock. I provided this image that we'll make into a pattern later. Its link is located in my video's description or project files. Go to Window and Browse Extensions Online. The Adobe Add-ons page will open. If you're not already signed into your Creative Cloud account, Adobe will ask you to sign in. Scroll down and click on Photoshop at the left. In the search field, type in Puzzle and press Enter or Return. Click Free Puzzle Pieces. When this page opens, click Install. Minimize or close your browser. Whether you're on Windows or a Mac, locate and open your Downloads folder. You'll see a zip file that says Puzzle Pieces. Double-click it to open the file and open the Puzzle Pieces folder. Click Puzzle.atn. Immediately in the Actions panel, you'll see a set of actions named Puzzle. If you don't see the Actions panel, go to Window and Actions. I'll expand the panel so we can see more of the 20 actions in the set. Each action will cut out between 2 and 192 pieces on separate layers. There are separate actions for each different aspect ratios and sizes within them. For this example, I'll click 96 pieces on a 12 by 8 puzzle. However, you can choose whatever you like. Whatever you do choose, we want to crop our image to that size. Open your crop tool and type into the width and height fields the same size as listed in the action you chose. Make sure you type in IN for inches. Make its resolution 150 pixels per inch. Make sure Delete Crop Pixels is checked. Click the check mark to crop your image. To fit it back onto your canvas, press Ctrl or Command 0. Click the Play button to play the puzzle action. Notice the action is creating individual layers that will comprise this particular puzzle. Since the puzzle I chose for this example has 96 pieces, there'll be 96 separate layers created in my Layers panel. You can see the selections of each puzzle piece being created by the action. When it finishes the last puzzle piece, this message will appear. It's telling us that we can adjust the bevel and drop shadow of all the puzzle pieces, and by clicking Continue, we should look at the top left puzzle piece as a visual reference for all the pieces. If we want to make adjustments to the bevel and/or drop shadow, we can do it here in the Layer Style window. In this case, I'll leave their settings as is, so I'll click OK. Instantly, all the pieces took on those attributes for their bevels and drop shadows. Now that we made our puzzle, it's time to make space all around it so we can add our background behind the puzzle. Go to Image and Canvas Size. Your canvas size is presently the same as your image size. I'll add 7 to 8 inches all around the puzzle. We can always crop it down later if we want. Then, click OK. To see your entire document, press Ctrl or Command 0. open the Retro Formica image I provided. To make it into a pattern, open your Move tool and go to Edit and Define Pattern. Name it whatever you'd like and click OK. Open back your puzzle document and in the Layers panel, scroll to the bottom. Make your background active and click the adjustment layer icon. Click Pattern and click OK. As you can see, the pattern adjustment layer made that one panel into an entire pattern. To see more of the Layers panel, drag its bottom down. Let's start repositioning individual puzzle pieces. Make sure Auto Select is checked. This automatically activates the corresponding puzzle piece that we click on. Go to View and make sure Snap is not checked. If it is, just click on it to deactivate it. Drag one of your puzzle pieces from its position. To angle it, open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. Go to a corner, and when you see a curved double arrow, rotate it to an angle you like. Then, press Enter or Return to accept it. Continue these steps for other puzzle pieces that you'd like to reposition. If you want one particular piece to be on top of the other pieces, drag that particular puzzle piece to the top of the Layers panel. Continue to move pieces until you're happy with their positions and angles. Next, we'll add a drop shadow to the entire puzzle. First, let's group all the puzzle pieces into a folder. To do this, drag the slider to the bottom of the Layers panel and make the bottom puzzle piece layer active. Drag the slider to the top and shift-click on the top layer to make all the puzzle pieces active. Press Ctrl or Command G to place all of them into a folder. Click the FX icon and click Drop Shadow. Change the blend mode to linear burn and the opacity to 40%. Uncheck global light and for the angle type in 90. Make the distance 12 pixels and the size 15 pixels. Click Bevel and Emboss. The style is inner bevel. The technique is smooth, the depth is 100%, and the direction is up. Make the size 4 pixels, and uncheck global light. Make the angle approximately 143 degrees, and the altitude 30 degrees. Make the highlight mode linear dodge, and the opacity 80%. The shadow blend mode is multiply and its opacity is 50%. Then, click OK. Next, we'll angle our puzzle in perspective. Make a composite snapshot of your entire image by pressing Ctrl-Shift-Alt-E on Windows or Command-Shift-Option-E on a Mac. Zoom out of your document by pressing Ctrl or Command and the minus key on your keyboard. Go to Edit, Transform, and Perspective. Go to a bottom corner and drag it out until you like its perspective. Then press Enter or Return. To crop your image, open your Rectangular Marquee tool and drag a rectangular selection over your document. go to Image and Crop. Then fit it back onto your canvas. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.